Welcome. Welcome to the fourth week of the Black History Program at the State Capitol, done by the Black Caucus. And so we welcome you to our art gallery. Today you will see an art gallery that is the returning citizens that have done art beyond the bars. And so the beautiful artwork, this is a piece that is actually done on a potato sack. And I want to say this was done when Mr. Weaver was still incarcerated. And this is an amazing piece that captures the pain, right? And the struggle. This is also another beautiful piece by Mr. Weaver. Mr. Weaver, can you join us?
Yes.
Mr. Weaver is an artist that is a returning citizen that has done this great work in 18 other pieces that I will show you. And tell us about this piece, Mr. Weaver.
This piece here is called Wedding Ceremony. And it took me about almost a month to do these beads. And I promised myself I wasn't going to do another bead picture, but I ended up doing another bead picture anyway. This piece came about because I was doing some research on African wedding ceremonies. And this was in a book by Beckworth and Fisher. And the picture was so captivating, the painting of the face and everything, and to be able to capture the bone structure up under the painting.
Yes. And so I see the detail that's even in the background concept.
The texture.
The texture that pulls in the hair and the beads.
What I did to create this texture is I put it on a cardboard box, and I ripped the box and opened it up so that I could create texture.
Really?
Yeah, so I learned a few techniques on how to do different things, but this is one of my favorite pieces because this gives you a history of the African wedding ceremony series. There's several other pieces that I did which are wedding ceremony pieces. I only brought this particular one today, but these wedding ceremony pictures were very powerful, and so they're very, very powerful.
Well, I tell you, your art is amazing, including the one that is on the potato sack.
Well,
how amazing this is
one, this? This one was done because I couldn't afford no canvas or no materials. So I worked in the kitchen, so when I would empty the potato bags, I would just throw me a few of them to the side, and I would paint on them.
And what would you use for your paint, even? It's just beautiful.
At the time, I was taking the latex wall paint, and I would cover it, and then I had a few old rusty colors. I had the five primary colors.
Okay.
And I would mix the different colors to create all of the other colors. And that's how this piece came about. This piece was done.
Tell us what is symbolic of.
This is symbolic of where I was at the time. I was incarcerated. I had over 100 years. I was trying to free myself, and I started giving time back and cases getting dropped, and I ended up with 30 years in the federal system, and this is one of my first pieces that I ever showed. And so this is real dear to me. It's in my personal collection. It is not for sale.
Dang on it, because I love it. It is amazing. But I love
sale.
Your work. I can't wait to show them
and
some more of your work.
This piece here is symbolic of what I was going through.
It was my struggle, my pain. Yes.
And
captured it.
I was teaching myself how to paint.
This is a teaching.
Yes.
Wow.
This was teaching myself how to paint. And
wow.
This is what I came
up with. It was your outlet.
And that was my therapy. That was my way of not getting in trouble. It was my way of doing something positive and trying to pave the way so that when I re-entered into society, I would be able to take care of myself because I knew a job wasn't promised to me.
Right.
So I taught myself to paint. And I watched this guy named Bobby West. I watched him for a year. Now, I guess I bugged the hell out of him because he would be like, "Go away, Weaver Bay. You bother me. Go away." But I would leave and I would come back 15 or 20 minutes later and I asked, "Bobby, why you do that?"
Uh-huh.
And so that's how
that's how you learned.
That's how I learned how to paint, and that's how this piece came about.
Well, as you see, we have returning citizens that have art that is amazing. But let me show you some more. So I think she's one of my favorites. And also, remind me of what you told me the name of the piece was.
This piece has a title that comes from Central Congo. It's called Kitoko Batu Uwasi, which means beautiful black woman. And I learned the language from an individual that I was incarcerated with in the Wisconsin prison system from Central Congo, one of my brothers. We're family now. But it's an inspiring piece. I love it. My brother said, it's not for sale.
But it's so just, what does it mean? What does it mean?
It's if you look at the symbolism of the picture,
yes.
You have different tones in the skin. So it represents a transition from darkness to light and from light to darkness. We have the Egyptian Ankh symbol here, which is a representation of life and other principles and values that connect our women to the universe and connect us to them. So this is actually a piece that, you know, is very dear to me, and it shows, you know, my honor and respect for women and you know, across the board, but particularly women of African descent.
Why, thank you. On behalf of women of African descent, I feel the royalty, I feel the beauty, I feel the love that's in that. There's a glow about her. I see her naturalness. And so I see all that in it, and just how you've captured the features that exist on women of color. And so, you know, and she's voluptuous, so, you know, I'm feeling her.
Well, I had a lot of fun doing it because actually this is not on canvas. This is done on a piece of board.
Okay.
And actually it came out of a period of time when I was experiencing some high levels of anxiety and stress. And I saw a piece of board laying on the ground and I grabbed it. And then I grabbed my paints.
So you used it as therapy?
And I went and got busy.
Wow.
As therapy.
Wow. You know? So that's something that we hear is the therapeutic component that art has provided both inside and outside the walls. Okay, so this piece is very powerful. And, you know, it speaks for itself to me.
Yes.
But it's something too that the one guy who is like fighting in the picture is Malcolm. I mean, not Malcolm, it's Martin. And the one that I would have thought would have been the one that's speaking up and fighting is Quiet.
Exactly.
And the one that's like, see you, you know, and that has really been the epitome of the dream is President Barack Obama,
this
who
piece,
I miss very much.
This piece is called Yes, We Did.
Yes, We Did.
Yes, We Did. And so many things went through my mind.
So he kind of like going, yes!
Of course.
Okay.
And then nobody expected Dr. King to be a fighter. But I know that in the later years of his life, he was in transition.
Yes.
And maybe even questioning the path of nonviolence. Nobody expected Malcolm to be silent. Very vociferous. Another man that was in transition. Our first African-American president. Nobody wanted to give him a chance in transition. And it speaks to what we've lost in our community and the strength of our black males in our community. And so I was hoping that this piece would also encourage some of our young men and young women to take on that same call. Yes, we did. Yes, we can.
Okay, so this truly is one of my favorites. Okay, I say that about all of them. So, but tell us about this piece.
This piece is called Freedom.
Oh, wow.
If you look at the piece, that would probably be the last concept or idea that comes to mind. But I wanted people to look at it and think about the title of it and just exchange their reality for that one moment. For a lot of us, for a lot of those who came before us, this was the only symbol of freedom that existed. The chains, the handcuffs, the hands reaching forward. And it's also a cross-cultural piece because I have a lot of friends and associates who come from other countries. Okay, so you have the representation of the person of color and then you may have the person from, you know, European descent. So we're all at risk. And let us think about what it means to be free.
Wow. Oh my goodness, thank you so much. Thank you for sharing. We continue to have different artwork, and we have Mr. Brown who exhibits his art. It's beautiful, but I have to tell a secret about Mr. Brown's art. This is work that was done even within the last 24 hours. Mr. Brown has done work on wood. He's done some beautiful pieces of Marsha Coggs and Isaac Coggs and others. But this is just an example of the depth of his talent. Mr. Brown?
Yes.
Please tell us about your pieces.
Here we have Josephine Baker, who is an entertainer and also a singer. And what I'd like to say about her piece is we all have a song. We all have the words inside. And it's up to us to look inside of ourselves and find out, what is that song? How can we reach other people with our gift, our music, and our light so it can shine? So that's why I wanted to pick her, not just her beauty, but her inner beauty as well. Also, we have Jean-Michel Basquiat, who is my favorite artist. He had a very unique style in which I depicted some of his techniques here. A lot of his work, he uses literature. He writes, you know, words on his paintings, which is very creative to combine literature, writing, and art. So he's very pioneering artist. And his life is very interesting, so one of my favorites. And one more thing about Jean-Michel is we all have art inside, and it's up to us to find that art, find that beauty, and share it with the world. And that's what he did at an early age. And now his work is worth multi-millions of dollars, so it's paid off significantly. So, and I also have Maya Angelou, renowned poet. And likely, she is one of the greatest poets.
Oh, for sure.
One of my favorite poets. And we all have poetry inside. We have creativity, creative language that we can tap into. It's her gift, but what is your gift? What is my gift? So we're looking inside ourselves to find our talents, the song, the art, the writing, the poetry, and releasing that so we can be better citizens and let our light shine.
You know, it's something that you say that because it's next to a poster whose words, I think, go to exactly what you said. You're not judged by the height that you've risen, but from the depths that you've climbed. And your work, I think, is a reflection in including the artists and the people that you've chosen to write about. And so I think it's so symbolic how those things have come together. And I thank you for being a part of the Reentering Citizens Art Beyond the Bars display that's in the Capitol. And one of my other favorite pieces is truly an amazing piece by Mr. Weaver. More of Mr. Weaver's work. And so at least if we can scan it, Mr. Weaver, if you could share some of what's happening with this piece, and then let's just scan the other pieces and so that we can see the other artists. But let's talk about that piece, Mr. Weaver, if you would.
Well, this piece here is a national art-winning piece. I won the National Art Festival contest in pastel at the VA hospital in 2016 with this piece. And it's called Thank You for Seeing Me as a Veteran and Not a Homeless Man. And at the time when I won the art contest, I was sleeping in a van. I was homeless. I had just been released from prison. I had been out of prison a short while. And I saw this picture on the internet. And it was so compelling, the eyes were so compelling, that I knew I had to paint it. And I painted it for my own personal use. And one of the art therapist counselors at the VA hospital, I showed it to her, and she told me, take this picture and enter it in the contest. And I was like, nah, I ain't gonna enter it in the contest. I just did this piece for myself. And she said, no, take this piece and enter it into the contest. So I entered it and two other pieces. And I ended up winning two first place and a second place. And then this piece went from the local to the regionals, and from the regionals to the nationals, and then I won in the nationals. So I beat out a lot of people to get to the nationals, to the VA Art Festival, because they have like 142 hospitals and artwork from all of those hospitals are in it all across the country. So to make it to the Nationals was a real feat with this piece. And so I received an email when a story was did on me in the Sentinel Journal about a month ago from the Volunteers of America. And they told me that they wanted to purchase this piece and they wanted to write a book of essays and include my story. So this past week, I just sent the essay to them to go in the book, and I'll be going to Washington, D.C. in a few weeks to present this piece to the Volunteers of America and sell it. I think it'll do a whole lot more good there in the national office there, because it's a very powerful and compelling piece, than it'll do with me. But I actually did this piece to go in my own personal collection. But it's gotten bigger than me. And so I'm going to have to part ways with it. That's why it's shrink-wrapped and ready to go on, because it no longer belongs to me in so many words.
Yes, but it is truly a piece that brings power. There's something in that guy's eyes, in the work, in your work, in what you've done that says so much. It is something that when you did the piece, that you too were homeless.
Yes.
At the time that you did the piece, and so that is just so amazing. And so as you can see, Mr. Weaver's work is amazing, and the art gallery continues with Black Jesus. I love that.
That's the real Jesus.
All right. And then dance. The power of art and dance is so powerful.
Miles Davis.
Wow, and he's in pink and green as an AKA. I'm loving that. I love this.
And this is Nanny.
That's Nanny.
Nanny is what Harriet Tubman is to the Americans. Nanny is to the Jamaicans in Jamaica.
Oh, well, I know that Representative Bowen will appreciate Nanny
and
because
Nanny,
he is from Jamaica.
And Nanny, the name of this piece is I Took That, or Did I? I'm talking about the red coat.
Okay.
Because the British were constantly trying to going to the hills of Jamaica and recapture slaves. And so Nanny led a group of Maroons who overthrew a slave ship and went into the hills of Jamaica. And so she is a pioneer in Jamaica to the freedom fighter. She's a freedom fighter. She was a freedom fighter like Harriet Tubman was.
Oh,
and
wow.
She led many Jamaicans to freedom. Yes.
Okay.
It's
I
a
thought
woman.
It was a man. This is a woman.
It is a
I
woman.
I did not know. Well, go on, girl. More power to you.
Yes. And so
on the
back of this piece, I have a little narrative that I wrote. And it says, I took this, or did I? And it's Queen Nanny. And it says, portrayed by Remy Cox, Renee Cox, Maroons. And so the Maroons are very prevalent in Jamaica. And anybody that knows Jamaican history will understand what Nanny did. And that's why I painted this piece. And then the next piece is an abstract piece. And I just felt that that man needs to be coming through that mask to peek outside of there and see what he could see. And so this is like a landscape inside of a statuette. And I never titled this piece. I just always liked the beauty of the color of it. And then the next piece is dollars and cents. That's what they sold us for. And it's indicative of the cotton plant and why we were brought into this country as laborers. And up in the corner, you see the slave ship in the background. And this woman in anguish is crying out because her son or husband or brother has been taken. And that's the power of this piece. And these are the original handcuffs that they used on slaves back in slavery. And that's why that looks that way. And he looks so sad. And the piece behind it is called Sharecroppers. And this is indicative of people who had came out of slavery and were getting prepared to till the land, and that's why their clothes and their hats are not all raggedy and everything, because they were landowners or were trying to be landowners. They were sharecropping the land for part of their take in whatever they grew. They would pay part of that for the seeds and everything and then get it back. So that's what that piece is about. And then this piece is called Totem Pole. This is a abstract piece with a fertility sign in the center. And that fertility sign is indicative of what our women went through in Totem Pole. This is the pipe smoker, and our ancestors smoked pipes. And this is indicative of what our ancestors did back then. It could be considered a peace pipe, really. And this piece here, this is Granny. This is about AIDS. This is about AIDS in Africa. And when the daughters and the fathers died from AIDS, the grandmother was left to take care of the babies. And this still goes on in Africa today. So this picture is very dear to me because it's about the babies, and that's our future. It's really not about us.
Well, then tell us, please, Luther. Mr. Hall?
Hi, I'm Luther.
Tell us about your work.
This one, quite simply, is I'm a man. Being a black man today, laced with a whole lot of interesting social issues in such an interesting time, I felt it necessary that we highlight the dignity and quality of black men. This is kind of derived from civil rights photos during protests during the 60s. And this one is called Rise Up. This one pretty much speaks for itself. I'm about self-determination and self-empowerment and self-encouragement. That's why I'm also a very big advocate for the arts for children as well as people who are on the inside, because it gives them a vehicle to not only express themselves but also support themselves once they get out. So I'm partly an educator, and a lot of my stuff is children inspired, like from cartoons and animation, and that's it. So thank you.
Give us a picture inside that.
Oh yeah, you got it.
Notice the black fist punching the eye of God. No, I'm just kidding. Not God. I'm just kidding. Joke.
All right. And then, Mr. Weaver, is this is more of your art?
Yes.
Which is beautiful. My goodness. Dance. Yeah.
Abstract. That's another abstract. And this
she
piece
just
here,
grabs your eyes.
This piece is breaking out. I was trying to come up out of there. That was breaking out. That was indicative of where I was at. And
what's
I was trying
this
to.
Piece?
This is Rocking My Soul in the Bosom of Abraham. Oh. And this is inspired by an Alvin Ailey dance troupe dance.
And who is this one?
This one here is a. This was a festival in the island of Grenada, I think it is. And it was just a ceremonial piece that I saw in a magazine, and like, it was just so. It just caught my eye. It was so bright.
What's this one? This is another abstract kind of concept.
This piece here is an abstract, but this is a piece that I did when I found out that my nephew had been killed by a drunk driver, and
oh,
so that's
goodness.
What I was feeling at the time. He had been hit on his motorcycle, and he got all broke up, and so that's what came out of me. That was the energy that came out on that piece.
Well, then I am always excited to be able to introduce you to another artist. Our only woman that is on display has her artwork on display. Last but not least, please, Ms. Christina, tell us about your work.
Well, I have my three pieces here. Each one has Adinkra symbolism in. This one is She Remembers. It's the Sankofa sign based on, symbolizes knowledge and wisdom passed on. So getting our history told and remember our past. And it's represented by a woman because typically that's how our stories are told. Our women pass down stories to their children, our mothers, our grandmothers, sisters, and our aunts. The next one is a djembe, and that is a drum, which is typically used for communications, gathering, for people to come together. And I put, of course, Africa on there. And then we have the Ndinkra, the Wawa Aba, is a seed from a tree. And it stands for perseverance and toughness. So I figured with communication and that brings us together with the drum and the perseverance, we can overcome. And the last one,
I love it, of the family.
Is the family. We have here the Ibon, which is a fence, and it stands for love, safety, and security. And then on the bottom here is the Abusawa Pa, and stands for good family. So we have our family union, and the safety of the father, the security, the love.
Yes.
That's each piece.
Completely beautiful. So you have been in the middle of the art gallery by the Returning Citizens, Art Beyond the Bars. This is an amazing display of the talent of the human beings that are behind bars and the talent that helps to create healing and economic wealth for individuals. Welcome. Thanks for coming.